to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. So you got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go?
So the phone rings and it's Rich. And he goes, you guys want to go bobsledding? And we go, hell yes. The next thing you know, we're at the Whistler bobsledding track, staring down the fastest track in the world, going, what the actual f-.
We're here with Mr. Richard Brown and my lovely bride, Trina Holt. And we're about to do the stupidest thing I've ever done in my life. I'm pretty goddamn scared.
Starting from here, so we're going to go corner three, we're going to go four, five, six, seven, then we're going to come down here, and then Thunderbird by the time we hit the bottom.
How you feeling, David?
Pretty fucking scared.
So we get the two-bit tour, pull up to the platform. I am so excited thinking about all those cool Olympic action scenes we've seen on TV, and this is what we see.
Your job is looking after the back of the brakes.
Oh my god, we're gonna die.
Not instilling confidence.
Trina is like, oh my god, what the fuck?
Split.
Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? If I go, there will be trouble. And if I stay, it will be double. So you gotta let me know. Should I cool it or should I blow? Should I stay or should I go now?
Okay, David's on the track right now. Richard's piloting. I can hear them over on the corner over there. They sound like wind. They should be coming around that bottom corner any second, actually. I see them.
Speed to Rich Brown 118.5 and across the finish line at 1 minute 05.
Seriously, they just traveled 1,374 meters with a vertical drop of 152 meters. They did it in 1 minute and 5 seconds. Top speed, 118 and a half kilometers per hour.
So? Wait.
I can't see a damn thing. Whew. Yeah. It's awesome.
Oh yeah, that's a problem.
Sure, go ahead. Right. You want to help me with the scabs?
So day one, I got 2 runs in. David got 1. We stayed the night at the very posh Athletes Village. Yeah, we're athletes. So we grabbed a big breakfast at the Wildwood Cafe, and that would be our last meal until dinner.
Okay, what you got there, David?
4 eggs, Benny, corned beef hash, bacon, crab, and I can't remember.
So I've got your basic bacon and eggs classic. Big nasty carbs. Life is good. Breakfast gone, big deep greasy carbs wins. Oh yeah.
It snowed a bit overnight, so our first daytime look at the track was all white. We had to use these ice clamps on our boots so we wouldn't slide to our deaths on the track. I thought they were kind of kinky. Richard took a minute to explain a bit about the international competition we'd entered, the BC Cup.
We're going to be doing something called a consistency race.
Okay.
And what it is from other starts other than the top. And what we're going to do is we're going to try and make our time as close on every single run. And then what happens is the person who gets the most consistent runs over the span of the race takes home the gold medal or the silver medal or whatever.
Right then.
So that's the plan. Rich and David loaded up into their bobsled and we got to meet some really nice people. This is Nick. He's the judge, jury, and executioner. And these crazy people ride these teeny tiny little sleds called skeletons.
A skeleton track, Laura Coots to the Lorman start down.
After the skellies were gone, it was Rich and David's turn. Romaine gave them a push. Push.
Thanks,
and they're down the mountain for another freakishly fast ride, followed by a truck ride back up the mountain, and then it's my turn again. Did you see me? No? Do it again. There I am, in the back. See? Alright, last run of the day, and we're to the pub, getting down to the real business, which is, of course, beer. This is where we were talking, and actually we realized, we might actually place in this competition.
Race one?
Day two. Good times?
Yeah.
So, times are pretty good. 103.76 and 104.38. Pretty consistent.
Holy shit, Rich. We were 0.01 off.
But we should place with those speeds.
Man,
yes.
Being the warrior athletes that we are, we went back to the hotel for damage inspection and a little nap before taking a snowy drive into Whistler Village.
It went all whistlery last night, so we got about 6 inches of snow, and it's looking pretty good.
Up there's Whistler Village. Whistler pretty.
So we're plowing through 6 inches of fresh snow, so we might as well have fun with it.
Yeah.
It's race day. Richard and the other pilots are getting serious. Some visualization, some stretching, gearing up, and some last-minute tune-ups to the sled. The plan is for me to go first because I'm lighter than David. That way Rich can slow down the second run to match the first run. And it was a good plan. My run was great. I wanted more. Then it was the big moment where Rich would attempt to match the speed of the first run with a different brakeman of a different weight on the second run.
That makes me happy.
Track is clear for Rich Brown to lower ends.
Let's do it.
Woohoo! And they're off. The next time I saw them, they were back at the top of the hill, and here's what David had to say.
That's pure adrenaline. Just finished the run, put the sled away, now we're going back down for the ceremonies. We'll let you know how we did.
So 27 one-hundredths out between our two runs, which is really, really good. Going off of corner three, David and I had to adjust for the weight a little bit. So we dragged corner eight to try and get our speed down a little bit. We went down a little further, a little faster, came out of corner 14 too late. Almost rolled it into 15. But we corrected it on an aggressive turn. It all worked out, and being 0.27 of a second out is pretty good.
We knew we did well, so when she got third, we knew we probably had silver or gold.
With only 0.27 seconds in between their runs, we have Rich Brown and David Chalk.
Oh my god!
We tied for gold!
Trina Holt.
Come
here, buddy.
Okay.
By the way,
awesome. Okay. So I serve with you.
Thank you.
There you go. There's one there, and yeah, you guys are gonna have to share one of those.
Awesome.
Thank you. You're welcome.
The fuck out by all of this.
That's amazing. That is so fucking impressive.
Holy shit.
That was so cool.
Two different brakemen, and you still pulled it off, Rich.
And we took home hardware.
We took home first place hardware.
That's the first time I've had multiple orgasms.
Did we give you guys an unusual week?
You did it that.
So here we are. We're making a big fast run to the ferry terminal. Woo!
Hoping for the best.
Hoping for the best.
Hoping that our luck that has been good so far continues to hold.
Yeah. Because the ferries have been down for days. Mom and Dad have been out of power since Thursday morning. It's now Sunday afternoon. So hopefully the ferries are running. Hopefully the wind isn't too hard. Hopefully the roads are going to be okay. No icy spots or any surprises. Yeah.
Three of us heading off to Nanaimo, please.
Three adults from Nanaimo?
Yeah.
Darling, you got to let me know. Should I
All right. Well, it was going to be a great weekend. Kind of an unusual weekend, but lots of fun.
Wait, the three of us? I'll be here till the end of time. We are athletes. We won gold.
For consistency.
No, gold winning athletes.
Oh my god. Thanks.
Good night, guys.
Good night, guys.